Everyone, thank you for joining. My name is Dorri, coming to you from the Downtown Spa and Relaxation Center here in Georgetown. We are hosting our third episode of Age, It's Only a Number. Today we have our guest speaker, May Rodriquez. She is an integrative health nutritionist. She's going to join us in a couple of minutes. We're going to welcome soon my co-host, Dr. Lorraine Wilson. Is she there yet? She's not there yet. All right, in the meantime, I just wanted to let you know that next week is our fourth episode. It will be our last one on this topic, but we plan to continue into July. Probably not every week, but we do have something planned for July the 15th. We have Meryl DaCosta. She is a registered physiotherapist, and she's going to talk to us about pelvic health. All us women need to know a little bit about that. I do remember when I was teaching fitness classes back in the day, jumping up and down like a banshee with both of my children. One of my participants in the class came over to me and said, "Now, dear, I don't think you ought to be doing that." And I'm like, "Oh, I'm fine. No problem. Don't worry about it." And I'm here to tell you, we're worried about it. So anyways, I am so looking forward to knowing more about the pelvic health. We also will have in July, Pauline Farquhar, who will be working out of the downtown spa as well. She is a hypnotist. So she deals with quitting smoking. She is actually the reason why my husband no longer smokes. Hallelujah. So blessed to have met her. She also deals with weight management, relationship issues, fears, how to conquer, you know, public speaking, that kind of thing. So a date has not been set for that, but it will be one of those Thursdays in July. So hello, Lorraine. I see you are on with me now. Welcome.
Thank you. Yeah.
No problem. So I think you wanted to catch up on a few questions that we didn't get to last week with regards to our skin.
Yeah, but you know, I think what might be interesting for our listeners is if you just mentioned how long Mike was a smoker for, because it's pretty phenomenal.
Mike had smoked from probably guesstimating, I would say 15. He did quit once before with the same tactic, hypnosis, but unfortunately he picked it up again probably, I'd say 10 years after quitting, and has just been going strong ever since. And of course, no one in our family smokes anymore. So he was always like the black sheep of the family, stepping outside to smoke and whatever. So we're all so happy and grateful and proud. We're proud of him too, because it's not easy. Not easy at all. But I'm here to tell you that if Mike can do it, you can do it too. Anybody can do it. You have to want to, of course.
Yeah.
She's really good. Like, she'll bring you in. She does a consult with you first. And if she thinks that you may not be that ready right then and now, she might ask you to, you know, go and come back when you are a little bit more ready.
I think that just speaks to her integrity as a practitioner.
Absolutely. She's lovely. She's lovely.
So, regarding the questions, back on topic, there is a couple, we have quite a few that we didn't get to. But I think two that might be really important, and they're kind of related for, if you could speak to it today, is one of the, well, there were several questions, but one of them was surrounding acne, like middle-age acne, postmenopausal acne, all that kind of stuff. And the other one, which can be related, was regarding like just having such sensitive skin. And, you know, people buy products and then, you know, their skin reacts, and then what do you do with it? So I thought maybe it would be good to focus on for now, and then maybe we can move into May.
Sure, sure. Well, sensitive skin, middle age, is usually associated with hormonals or it can be a form of rosacea cuprous skin that looks like acne. In our teens, acne, you know, most of the teens have acne due to hormonal imbalance, excess sebum in the pores, and of course, clogged pores, just by not, excuse me, washing correctly or often enough. Mm-hmm. Stress has been linked to hormone imbalance, but there's no link to stress and acne. Also, foods have not been linked to acne, but I am a believer that allergies to certain foods or even intolerances to sugar, wheat, and dairy do affect the skin. I know myself, I can have two potato chips or one chocolate, and I know that I'm having a pimple. So I would suggest, like for the younger, you know, the teens up to early 20s, more hormonal, but definitely your routine of cleansing. And the one thing that's very misunderstood about acne is everyone always assumes that it's oily skin. I have acne, I have oily skin. Not always the case. Oily skin, yes, can be problematic for acne, and in which case you will use products accordingly. But if you are using stripping or abrasive products on a skin that is not oily, then you're just causing more acne because you're stripping the oil and the skin is going, oh, we need more oil, we need more oil. So there comes the oil. So now you're on the hamster wheel. I would say that teen acne, middle age acne, redness, cuprous skin, broken capillaries, all the way sensitive products, definitely. Sensitive cleansers, toners, products that have calendula, aloe vera, marshmallow extract, those kinds of products help to calm the skin. Chamomile is very calming to the skin. I would say nothing abrasive. You've got to watch your exfoliants. You really want an exfoliant that when you're using it, the water is making it dissipate so that it's not like granular, like a kernel. Apricot kernels are very, very abrasive. So I don't suggest those for acne or for sensitive skin. Definitely not.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I guess the question is, to be fair, we'll probably talk about this in another show, but you have, maybe just a little tidbit, you have a way to sort of help people figure it out, don't you?
If they're having excess oil and they're acneic, or are they cuprous capillaries? Of course. I mean, we would look at your skin under a magnifying lamp, which that makes such a huge difference, right? And products. I don't suggest try and buy and go use. No, like get yourself a proper professional skin analysis done. Save yourself a lot of time and money and know what you're putting onto your skin, making sure that's going to be beneficial for your skin, definitely.
And you do that at the spa, Dorri? Yeah,
absolutely, we do. My specialty.
Oh, yeah. Awesome. In to show it too. So.
Oh, thank you.
So I've seen her up close, so I can say that. but maybe what we could do now is our guest ready? Or
I think so. We're going to invite May Rodriquez into the room with us. And May is going to tell us a little bit about herself, her craft, and how she's going to implement it here at the Downtown Spa. Welcome, Hello. May. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate this opportunity.
No problem. No problem. So why don't we start off? You can tell us a little bit about yourself, how you got into the industry that you're in, and what we can expect to learn and have from you at the Downtown Spa.
Great. Yes, I'd love to talk a little bit about this. So how I got into hair mineral analysis, I was around it for actually many years. I worked at a sleep clinic, and I was always really fascinated with the metabolic system. And, you know, from being around it, I just always thought there was a different way of helping people, like, naturally. So I started, you know, diving into it a little further. And then, you know, I started working with someone who could mentor me a little more about it. I read all about it. And after moving to a different city, I decided to help people, you know, naturally. And just I ventured off into a different career. So now I'm into the wellness. So I help coach and I help transition or transform lives, you know, naturally. Which is, you know, technically what a lot of people are looking for now.
I think so. I think, especially after COVID, I find people are really wanting wellness naturally, and they want to self-help, you know, themselves. But in order to do that properly, you need to have a little bit of education behind you, right? So what does the word integrative nutritionist, what does that entail?
So it just means holistically, like having an alternative, you know, medicine, right? So it really just means like being in touch more with like your body and understanding your bio-individuality and just, you know, healing naturally, right? Eating the right type of foods and aligning yourself with the right environment. That's very important. And just having your mind and spirit all aligned, you know, as one, right? So that's integrative.
Well, I can say that I have had this testing done. And what did I say to you? Oh, I feel pretty good. Like, yeah, I'm good. Well, hey, I was a little taken back with my results, you know. I thought I was a Miss Healthy Girl here. And come to find out, you know, minerals are very important. I mean, I knew that, but I didn't think I was lacking in them. And now I know that I am. So now I know what to take in order to offset that. So thank you for that insight. I can say that, you know, the testing was so easy. I mean, honestly, when you were standing behind me with the scissors in my hair, I'm like, excuse me, this is my trademark. What are you doing? But two little small pieces, right? That's all you need. And then it gets sent off to a lab, right?
Yeah. Well, and I was a hairdresser for so many years, so I knew exactly where to cut.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate that knowledge. Yeah.
Yeah, that came in handy.
Yes. Yes. So,
and you know, technically, like the purpose here, you know, by doing a hair mineral analysis is to maintain your health, right? And it's at a high level of functioning, right? And to prevent disease, because, you know, some of us are, you know, maybe just on the verge of falling, you know, into those footsteps, right? But by doing a hair mineral analysis, you can actually prevent, you know, following that line.
Yes.
It was really interesting when Dorri was telling me, May, about getting her, was that you could even tell from the hair, you know, almost like your hair is a timeline. And your hair will tell you kind of your history of maybe stress or life experiences or stuff. Can you speak to that a little bit?
Yes, of course. So because hair mineral analysis, it's really like tapping into the minerals that are already stuck to your hair, right? So what the lab does is it washes whatever toxic metals your hair actually has, you know, acquired over the years. And then they look at the minerals that your body, you know, needs or is deficient in. So technically, because, you know, mineral imbalances and toxic elements can aggravate our health conditions, we tap into it to help prevent, right? Or just, you know, help you live a higher quality of life.
So we have a couple questions because people were anticipating you coming. Mm-hmm. So one of them is, like, who is mineral analysis for? Like, who's a candidate for it?
Well, I would say, you know, children, elderly, adults, anyone who's missing missing minerals, right? As we get older, our body depletes, right? So we are literally depleting calcium and magnesium. Those are the two main ones, and other minerals as well, copper, zinc. And we're not aware of it, right? Because our food is different, right? So our toxicity levels are different. We use all these things around us that actually depletes our body of minerals, right? So, and it's not like back then when we had, you know, the beautiful soil full of minerals that, you know, we were around that a little bit more. Things have changed, right? But it doesn't mean that you can't go back to that. You can, you just have to look for it and live that lifestyle, right? Where you can put those minerals back into your body. It's literally for growth and development. So in children, it helps, you know, your brain development, growth, cardiovascular disease, high cholesterol, anyone who has thyroid imbalances, sleep disorder, malabsorption of nutrients, which I think a lot of us do. And I was there 2 years ago, so I knew. I was always tired, you know, and once I put myself through this entire system, I realize like how powerful this is. Like I'm up at 5:30, 6 a.m. and I go to bed at, you know, the latest 10, and I was never like that before. 3 kids later, I was always really exhausted.
I think it's very positive that both you and Dorri, I haven't had time, just so everybody knows, but that both you and Dorri are walking, like, are speaking from experience. And it sounds like even if you have maybe a child that has some health complications, they could come to you maybe for some additional or supplemental.
That's right. And there's so many autoimmune diseases, you know, nowadays. And if you've done a lot of like research, you've probably seen that a lot of this is induced by like a lot of our food supply. Our food supply is full of toxic metals, right? And not to say that everything is, but we just need to be coached or taught, you know, what the right foods for our body is. And some of us know, some of us just really need to tap into our gut and follow our instinct naturally, to eat the right kinds of foods, right? Cause we all sort of crave the right, you know, something, right?
So for people who would be, taking a vitamin a day, let's say a multivitamin a day, that'd be somebody who would not be suitable for this, or even then, like, it's really kind of something that would benefit if they came to you?
That's right. So you would just have a better idea what your body needs, right? So sometimes we make that decision to just take a vitamin, but do we know if we really need it, right? And the only way to know is if you test for it and see if there's a deficiency, or maybe you're really high in that mineral, like copper. We all seem to be a little bit high in copper nowadays, depending on, you know, how we're drinking water, the type of shampoo we're using, the type of foods we're eating, right? So do we really need to put copper into our body? You know, maybe not, or maybe we do, right? Maybe we don't have enough copper, but the only way to know is if you test for it.
And how does this procedure or testing process, how does it differ from just going to the doctor and getting your blood work done?
Well, technically a blood, you know, blood test really reveals like what your blood work really reveals what is maybe current, right? So maybe 2 hours, 4 hours, maybe 24 hours in your blood. That's really what it's testing for. They don't really test 2, 3, 4, 5 years. With a hair mineral analysis, you can see activity up to 10 years.
No real pattern. You can see a pattern.
Yeah, there's a pattern. Yeah, you can see a pattern in the hair, because the hair is so, you know, it just shows everything from your follicle, right? It captures everything from inside your body, which I think is fascinating.
Those are people who work out and eat right the week before they go to the doctors. This would like...
That's right.
Maybe that's what I was doing.
Yeah, that's what you were doing. That's what I was doing.
Yeah, one last question, May. What are the benefits of getting this done? Now, you talked about this a little bit, but maybe just a summary statement to close off.
Yeah, well, in summary, I find that assessing the balance of minerals in the cells, that's the real basis for nutritional balancing, right? So just having, you know, or having the knowledge behind what your body really needs, and then, you know, putting that in your bio-individuality together, you know, with what you crave, and just making swaps maybe for, you know, something you're already eating, but just a better choice can help, you know, restore that imbalance, right? You know, once you've had the test done. Also the hair mineral analysis, it's a biopsy that gives, you know, nutritionists and practitioners a much more definitive way of the person's metabolic, you know, rate, right? So are they a high oxidizer or a high metabolizer or a low metabolizer, right? And that's, it's also a better understanding of mineral deficiencies, right? And what are toxic, what is actually a toxic food supply?
I think it's just awesome that you are focused on the mind, body, spirit connection, looking mm-hmm. at picture, because that just fits in with the spa, right?
That's and right. Absolutely.
Able to offer your service is something that's mm-hmm. really that option. So thank you so much.
That's right. And the whole idea is to heal inside, right? The beauty does come from within, right? So the idea is to help you glow, help your, you know, skin glow and just live a better quality of life with energy.
With energy, absolutely. Yeah. I remember reading a few years ago on mm-hmm. nutrition, and I was really blown away by like one sentence that it said that you can take as many vitamins as mm-hmm. you want, mm-hmm. but it's actually the minerals that carry the vitamins yeah. to the body where needed. Mm-hmm. So we need to pay more attention to the minerals, I'm thinking. Is that mm-hmm. true?
That is very true. Absolutely. Actually, I just learned about a little while ago, we did a webinar and we talked about, you know, far like further north, they eat I think it's whale broth. Oh. And this is, yeah, these are whales that are found, but because they're so high in minerals, you know, you make a broth and that actually really nourishes your body, right? And you're not mm-hmm. hunting for them. They just come offshore sometimes and, you know, they die. But right there, there's such a mineral basis for humans, and people are not aware of this. I mean, the culture that really is in tune with that is the natives of Canada, which I find super fascinating.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I do. They really have something. They're very connected to that life, right? And mm-hmm. they're connected to nature. And, yes. you know, within our own nature, you know, that tradition, if we followed it, we would probably feel a little bit more energized.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Just one last question, May. So we're calling this the hair mineral analysis. Mm-hmm. So what if someone, you know, male is bald already, or is there anything else? I thought I heard.
Yeah. So
fingernails.
Yes. So great news. Yeah. Cause if you're bald, and that's a really great, question. Yeah. So if you're bald, you can't help it. Right. Yeah. So we do nail clippings now. So okay. The lab is now, you know, they're set up for that.
Okay. And it's just as,
it's just as
true to the board. Testing.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Wow, that was so interesting. Thank you so much for joining in today. We're going to do a draw for a little gift from you. Did you want to tell us about what that will entail? We have a consultation with you and a product.
Absolutely. So so what I would like to do is I would like to have like a discovery session with you know, with whoever wins the draw. Yeah. And I've also have I actually work with two companies. I work with Metagenics and Cytoplex.
Right.
Cytomax, sorry. And I've got collagen, which is really good for skin and nails.
Hair and nails and just about everything.
Joints. Just about everything.
It's one of my most favorite products.
That's right.
Okay, so we're going to spin. We do like a little, just so it's everybody gets a fair chance at it. We're doing it on our little wheel.
Beautiful.
And just to interject here, we're getting some great comments. Really, a lot of interest about the hair and the history. Great info. So people learning a lot, May. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you. No, thank
All
you
right,
guys.
All right, we have our winner. Probably can't see it, but it's at Julie, K-A-R-I-N-E underscore. So that is the winner of the consultation with May and the collagen nutritional. Okay.
Perfect.
Fantastic. Really, so we will arrange for Julie to get a hold of you. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we are still in lockdown, so mm-hmm. we do not have a date as of now when May will be joining us and when her mm-hmm. consultations will start, and neither for Dr. Lorraine either. So when we find out when we are ready to get going, we
Excellent.
Will send out emails with all of this information. Okay?
Yes, that would be amazing.
All right. Well, thank you so much, May. Thank you, Dr. Lorraine, my pal. And we will see everybody next week, same day, same time. It will be our last episode for this topic. And we do enjoy all of your comments, so keep them coming. And we're so grateful and happy that you decided to join us today. Thank you, everyone, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye.